Good morning, people. I don't have any makeup on because I thought, why not make a makeup video? A makeup video where we're also going to talk about things and going to answer questions, some questions. And on my Sandra Angelina YouTube channel, I am going to film the rest of the December readings. But it's a long time since I did like some kind of makeup video, so I'm going to do that today. I'm going to show you guys what I use, especially in the winter time. At this moment, I just got a new Palo Santo because I had a tiny piece and I gave it to one of my customers yesterday. I am that kind of person. Driving home for Christmas. Can you guys hear my singing? I, by the way, got this new, is it a bodysuit thing? With buttons? I don't know what you call that. I love it. Kiri showed me this, you know, online page where you can buy clothing. Is it Boohoo? I think it's Boohoo. Thank you, girl, because I love that page now. I bought some things, colorful things. I'm doing fitness again. I'm eating more clean and I am losing weight and, you know, I feel better. So it's going the right way. I am going to just, you know, talk about some beauty things today. So if you are a guy watching, I'm sorry if this is too much beauty and blah, blah. But would you please focus on me? I have so many questions about, like, thank you. You know, the beauty. Every time I look away, it's not even focused. I think we already have like spirit here. But I have a lot of questions about how I do my makeup, what I use, all that jazz. I have my magical vibing things today. There's one that reminds me of Christmas that I actually want to try. I think it's this, it's the love one. There's cocoa in it, but I don't know, because one of them, I don't believe it's this one. Oh, I like it. By the way, for the hands, I do use this. I mean, it's pretty normal. But again, I am, would you please, I am showing everything today because especially my girls out there, you are always asking. So I'm showing everything. I am using sponges from Real Techniques. These are the best ones. I know that you also have the, I actually have a lot of them here because I used them for my customers in the past. These are very disgusting. I'm just saying. They are very disgusting because I've been using them for Halloween looks. But I can't remember what this brand is called, but I don't use them anymore. Real Technique. If you haven't tried Real Technique and you are a beauty lover, you do need to try it. I have my water because I didn't take my Eidolin drops and I do want to show you guys. My friend Amanda got them and she tried to take them and she was like, my heart is beating. I'm shaking. I don't like this. Like, I don't know what's wrong with you. But, you know, I just press a little bit in the tube. I have my water ready. I'm going to show you guys. Oh my god. Oh, so disgusting. Oh, so disgusting. But, you know, oh, it's good for the brain. So I take these. I don't really have the opportunity to just brush my teeth right now. So, okay, give me a moment. I thought it would be better after some time, but it's still disgusting. But it's not supposed to be tasty, you know. Everything that's healthy is not really tasty. But yeah, I do have a little cream on from this morning, but it's not much. And again, this is all about showing you guys what I do, you know. I have these drops that I got from Kiri actually. It's so funny because she is Curry. Wow. Kiri is working at the airport and I don't know if it was something about a customer bought this but didn't want them anyway, forgot them, or there was something. So she gave it to me together with a night cream that I don't have here. I haven't really been good at using that night cream, but I do have to because, you know, me being 33, I do need to take care of my skin. I'm going to be honest with you guys, I do get Botox from time to time, but it's a year ago since I got Botox, so you can see that the lines are coming back. But again, you know, I am 33, so I have my dirty MacBook here because if I feel that I run out of questions, I might take some random questions. I have my candlelight thing I'm going to put on. But again, back to the drops. This is for it is for dry skin, and I do have normal to dry skin. Not super dry, but in the winter time, I do tend to get more dry skin. Plus, this is for, you know, for wrinkles. This really helped me. I feel that this helped me. I do also have something from Estee Lauder for under the eyes. Again, this girl needs to take care of her face. So I'm just going to, you know, take some drippy droppies and just... It's so hydrating. I love it. And I just put it on my face. Maybe I took too much, but whatever. But, you know, this is good for me when I'm here. When I'm in LA, my skin actually tends to be way drier, and I feel it's because of the water. Pack it on a little bit. I always put it on my lips because, again, take care of those lips. They are also very dry. I didn't take all my magic that I use, so... But I have this Biotherm... What do you call that? Biotherm? Lip balm. I'm going to use that today. Because it's actually pretty good. I also have this lip scrub from Jeffrey. Jeffrey, my boy! I met Jeffrey many, many years ago. When he was little Jeffrey. Little Jeffrey. When he was like, not the Jeffrey that he is today. Okay, so let's do this. My wild years. You are supposed to, like, I think you can eat it, right? Right? I'm going to take the brush. My lips are ready. But I am going to get Botox again. I know a lot of people are like, you don't need Botox. It's not good for you. It's not dangerous to get Botox. I mean, obviously it depends on, you know, where you get it and who is doing it. Don't do it yourself. But the woman who always do my Botox is, you know, she's like a nurse, or what you call that. So she knows what she's doing, but she is moving, so I actually don't know if I, you know, I have the time to get it done with her. But then again, it's not my priority right now, because paying off debt is what's on my priority list, because I do want to travel more, I do want to become free of the past. So that's what I'm doing. And then I will see. But I remember she told me back then when I, you know, actually have a video on this channel with the first time that I got Botox. I will put it up here if you guys want to see it. Oh, this just got so much more cozier after we got this light on. But she told me that you actually give Botox to, like, kids when they have, like, cramps to loosen it up, something like that. Why did I have this again? I think it's because it's normal for me that I'm doing reading for you guys, so I'm not doing that today. Again, I don't know how long this video is going to be, because this is just going to be me doing makeup and talking about a lot of things. Fixed my nails yesterday. I do gel nails myself because I do have the machine, so it's easier. I did use, what do you call that, the nail tips in the past, but now I just have my own nails. I do try to just use my own nails now. Becoming a grown up. But, alright, step two is cream. And I use this one. I got this from Amanda because she did work at something we call Matas in Denmark. Because it's not like Sephora, no. It's like, is it like Ultra? Or what you call that? I don't know what it is. It's just, you know, you can buy a lot of things. But again, this is also very hydrating. And again, hydration is something that my skin needs. Normally I just take, you know, I do this and then I do this, but now that I'm like using a mirror and I'm filming, and I'm doing it another way. We love hydration on the skin. Oh, I got another thing I have to tell you guys. Something that I recently just learned about is you can use apple cider vinegar to, you know, remove puffiness or remove the dark circles under the eyes. Also to remove skin tags, because I have one here. It's not that visible anymore. It's been very annoying. I remember that I cut it away. Maybe not the best to do yourself, but I did it. So, you know, I remember the doctor told me that I have some hormone unbalance in my body. Also because I haven't had my period since I was 12. That's why I'm always happy, because I don't have those period cramps or stuff like that. I don't deal with it anymore. When I was younger, my friends were always like, oh my god, I want to be like you, not having my period ever. Like, I don't mind it. I don't know how it is to be grumpy on your period. But the hormone thing was supposed to be, you know, affecting that I, at that time, got these, like, skin tags. But the rest, you know, they are just gone, but I still have this little one. But then I had a customer talking about the apple cider vinegar, that I should mix it up with water and then use it as tonic, you know, in my face day and night. And it's really doing something to the face, I'm telling you guys. Also, this is getting smaller and smaller. So, if you guys are dealing with that, or dark circles or pigment thingies on your skin, do it. You can use it on your whole entire body, she said. So, yeah, that's what we are doing. We are putting apple cider vinegar in our face. I have already been talking for 20 minutes or something like that, I feel, and I'm not even started with on my makeup. It is cozy. I also need to whiten my teeth. I use, is it Smile Science? I use that. That is the most safe brand to use. I actually heard from some of my customers that there was some Danish brand that really messed up people's teeth. And some Danish famous people even promoted it, and oh my god, without knowing that it was actually not a good brand. I can't remember what it was called. But Smile Science, if you want to use it, use it. I did have a coupon code at some point, but it's many years ago that I've been working together with them, so I don't think it works anymore. But I might try to contact them to get something new. But you can find it online everywhere, the coupon code. I don't know what kind of makeup I'm doing today. My battery is blinking. The foundation I'm using is Estee Lauder. It's what works best with my skin at the moment. I have this one that I'm usually using is Porcelain, because that I am a white beaut. Would you please show the people what this is? If you are as white as me, let me know. And I have this one. It's actually very dark, but for some reason, I don't know why, my skin feels darker than this one, but too dark for this one. So I make these get together and shake up and make a baby that fits me. So that's what I'm doing today. I don't really have that much. Amanda, again, my girl always buys things for me. So she needs to send me what she got me. Because again, I don't have any more. She was in Copenhagen actually doing some, she's doing lashes. So she went to, I will put her link somewhere. She went to the, what do you call that, where you learn it. So while she was walking around in Copenhagen, we were talking together and she was, you know, going into Sephora and shopping for me while I was on the phone. That's just how we do it. I still don't know what I'm doing right now. But yeah, I might answer some questions that I got from my other page and some older ones from this page. It's Moagus. But you did ask me a lot of amazing questions, so I do want to find your comment again. I know that I have it on my laptop. I can't remember what video that was. All right, found it, because you have a lot of amazing questions. I'm going to show it here. The first question is, what are you doing when you're not making videos? That's a good question. If I'm not making videos, I'm making videos. I'm going to answer your question. By the way, do you guys remember this? It's from another video. Kiri, you know what this is, if you're watching. What am I doing if I'm not doing videos? Well, first of all, I am self-employed photographer, so I do take pictures of people. I edit pictures, the recording stuff. So my day-to-days are actually just about taking pictures, editing the pictures, filming, using this magic. Right now, that's my life. I'm working a lot. Besides that, I am, you know, what do I do to relax? I do meditate a lot because, again, it is a part of doing this psychic work. I do read. I love to just sit outside, you know, just look out, look at the nature, the trees, everything, that kind of things. I'm going to remember to show you guys what I'm using. Anastasia Beverly Hills. This is the granite. Now that I have the darker hair again, I do use this one. But that is what I do. I know that might be boring, but that's why I don't do daily vlogging yet, because again, right now my life is just about that. Filming, working. I'm trying to find a mirror that I really can handle here. But I am going to do daily vlogging when I get my own place at some point. Then I don't need to be aware of other people around me. And that's one of the problems with the girl that I'm living with. And she's not really a camera thing, and it's like her apartment, so I can't just, you know. That is the problem. But I do want to find my own place, but again, right now that's not my priority. When I make more money with YouTube, it will be my priority. And again, me being a Libra, I like beautiful things. So obviously I want to find a good place. I'm not just going to take a place that I, you know, don't feel comfortable with. Okay, we are doing brows. I'm not too careful when I do my brows, because I'm going to fix up all the mistakes anyway. But yeah, right now that's pretty much what I do when I don't travel. I love to travel, and I am in 2020, me and Kiri, we are going to do more traveling. Yeah, that's what I love. That's what I enjoy. And then you also ask how old I am. And I did say that earlier, that I am 33. Didn't I say that earlier? Maybe I said it wrong. Did I say it wrong? I don't know. But I am 33. I am in my 30s. And some people, especially Amanda, was like freaking out when she got in her 30s. And I'm just like, well, I feel grown up now. Most people, you know, they have like kids and are married in my age, and I'm just here and single and doing YouTube. I am free spirited. Okay, so I'm going to mix the foundations up if it works. Oh my god, I really don't have a lot left. And you did also ask about, what was it again? Oh yeah, the name Sandra Angelina. It is, my name is Sandra, but the Angelina was more like a... Camera died. But it is more of a stage name. Because I was like, well, Sandra, that's boring. I do have my middle name is Krak. It is from Holland. It's the Nederland. That how you call it? Oh my god. Sorry for my Nederlandish, you know. I never lived there, but you know, it's in my genes, I guess. I did do a DNA test and put it up here. I'm even 1% Finnish. I mean, who would have thought that? 1 or 4%, I can't remember anymore. But the Angelina just, you know, it came in my MySpace days. If MySpace is still existing, I do actually believe that my MySpace page is still up. That was, oh my god, I was a bit of an emo back then. So I'm just going to put foundation on and I'm going to fix the brows. Driving in my car. I've been listening to Christmas music today. Can you guys hear it? But what else do we have? But yeah, I actually don't know why I chose Angelina. But the funny thing is that I've been speaking about this before, that I always tend to attract like psychic customers. Like, you know, you attract people who are supposed to come into your life to say certain things. And one of them told me that it was very fitting because I'm like an earth angel. Like, I am a light worker. I am here to help people. That's also one of the reasons why, you know, I'm not supposed to have kids in this life. Because that... again, it's not my mission to have kids in this life. And that is also linked together with, that's a bit more scary, that I have heard from two psychics now, that in my past life, the past life that I had before this life, that I got killed while I was pregnant. So apparently I said, you know, again, we chose some things in our life, what we want to go through, and I guess that I didn't want to go through having kids in this life. I did speak with Patty Negri to do some kind of like reading to find out about like that life. But then again, is it, you know, do I want to know what happened back then? Is it going to help me in some way? I thought that I really wanted that, but now doing more of this like beautiful things, okay. Spiritual things, I'm a little bit like, I don't know if I need to know. Also because I did my own digging and I have done a lot of like the past, like, you know, where you go into trance and you see things. So at some point I have a feeling, well, I know what happened, but again, it doesn't really matter. It's not a part of this life. But yeah, there was a lot of talk because of the about the name Angelina, but it just came to me. Yeah, and I had it ever since. And it's, I mean, I even have customers who just call me Angelina. It's so crazy. I have heard from so many people that like the Angelina apparently fits me better. So there is a reason why we choose names, or why we choose, you know, certain things in our life. I'm trying not to mess up my hair. But yeah, I'm what do you call that? Doing this, pressing it into the skin. Then I always have a lot of questions about like if I'm single, and yes, also the how long I have been single. It's a question that pops up on my other page a lot. I mean, I do love reading, so obviously that's something that people want to know. How many years have I been single? You should get to the point where you don't remember how many years you've been single is bad. Oh my god, I've been single for years, years, years. Many years. I am not... Again, I haven't had, like, real relationships. I only had... two big relationships. I am actually not the person who's like jumping from one relationship to another. I've been dating people, but that's not the same. It's not the same. But like being like seriously in a relationship, I actually think that I only had two that I really, you know, like remember. And this relationship, that's the first relationship was almost 6 years. The other one was almost 3, maybe. So, you know, I am not good with committing. And when I read in my like chart, I have Aquarius somewhere in my chart. I can't remember which one it is, but. It is the, like, I'm really bad at really committing to a relationship, and that's something I have to work on. And the fact that if I have been in a relationship, I have a tendency to stay in it even though it is bad. Or have a tendency to get bored. That's how you say that. Easily. Like, you know, I need new things all the time. Not that I need you know, a lot of people in my life. No, if I'm in love, I'm in love. But again, you do go through, you know, lesson relationships to build up for the big, final, magical relationship. But I don't know how many years it is that I have been single. Maybe, oh, should I give you guys a wild guess? I broke up with my last boyfriend. Maybe in 2014, maybe. No. Yeah. I can't remember, but I actually think it is. But again, I'm not someone who's just going into a relationship just to be together with someone. That doesn't work for me. Okay, I use Max. But as you guys can see, it is empty. This is just in light. Skin finish, natural. So I'm going to use this loose transparent powder that I use for my customers. So, okay. Oh my god. And in the past, I've been hungering for this, like, ooh, I need to be in a relationship. Also because me being a Libra, obviously we are, like, you know, the sign that ruled by Venus, so family and relationships are very important. But for me now, I'm like, I'm going to find the right person when I'm finding the right person. It's not my priority. And I do tend to fall in love pretty easily with people. That's another thing we Libras do. Libras! Who out there is a Libra? I didn't put that much foundation on. Even though that it is a very heavy foundation, but I love it.
The sun is shining!
Then I use my contour kit from Kat Von D, and I am using from Real Technique, I don't know what it's called, a contour, well it is called contour brush, but I use this one. So I use this and I dip it in, would you please show this one and this one. I just go for it. Please focus on me. But yeah. But the funny and interesting thing is that I have had a lot of... I have had 2 or 3... psychic people who told me that I'm going to be together with an English-speaking person. But the English, I mean, in Danish we say engelsk. And English can be British, but it can also be American. So, and the first psychic who told me this was years back when I was, oh my god, maybe 18? I think I was 18, so I was young. So back then I was like, wow, okay. And it's funny because he said to me, and again, it's like the terms of like how they see it. Like, she said that you're going to be a supermodel. Back then I was like, what does that even mean? Back then I was like, well, a supermodel, that's like Victoria's Secret models, you know. But again, it's an old-fashioned term, and she was an older lady. So I have friends who was like, well, that can't be you making YouTube or, you know, doing the modeling, because I've done so much of that. And she also said that she didn't see kids in my life, which back then it broke my heart, because back then I didn't know that I couldn't have kids. So, you know, she didn't say like, I don't see kids in your life, but she said that I was not going to be able to have my own kids. And, you know, back then I didn't even think about having kids. So it's been, her reading's been really like spot on. She actually also told me back then that I would live in another country, and it would be a major lesson for me, that experience. And I did live in France, because I lived with my ex-boyfriend, and that was a major lesson for me, because I learned a lot from that relationship. So again, I wish that I could remember what she said. Other than that, I can't. Another psychic told me that I was going to be old. I was going to die of old age. So, and just to think that I'm like a manifester. I remember that Patty told me that you are a manifester. You're a very good manifester. She also told me that she saw two men in my life that I was, that I had to choose between. That thing didn't happen yet. Maybe it did, I don't know. Well, you never know what's going to happen, right? I can't remember what else he said. Okay, so yeah, I just put highlighter on, you know, up here, on the nose, on the lips. I actually do, oh, it's not that bad. I'm going to fix my brows again, so I am going to take a little bit. I always do the thing where I take a little bit and I put it on here, so I make it flat. I don't know what you call that. So there is not too much on the brush. And I would also like to hear about your spiritual path. Okay, and you also ask about like how I became a YouTuber. I actually have had a YouTube channel many years ago. Maybe, I think I found it some time ago, and I sent it to Kiri, and we was just dead laughing about that channel. It's still out there somewhere. Back then, it's so funny because I love to do like movie trailers. You know, you can't do that stuff today because it's going to get demonetized. But I love to do that. I love to be creative. I love to edit. That's also my passion now, that I love to edit. I have to be better at filming, because again, I do still have this where I rush through things. I am getting better at that, but I'm still, you know, I still have the tendency to rush to things. I'm not taking the time to film like B-rolls, what you call that, like creative shots. I want to do much more of that. But back then it was all about editing like music or video trailers. I remember I did one for, what is it called, the vampire movie? Chocolate, Blood and Chocolate? Do you guys know that movie? I did one for that. That's so funny. If you guys ever find out the channel, you are for a treat. There's also a video where I box around with my back then Doberman. I had like, is that what you call it in American? The dog? I had it with my ex boyfriend back then. I actually always been guided to do YouTube because my ex-boyfriend from France, he's also a YouTuber. I don't think he's actually doing YouTube that much anymore. But I made a reaction video on this channel because he was filming all the time. And when I look back at it, today I'm like, why didn't I vlog back then? Because we experienced so many things. We were just so creative together. But he just had some struggles. But we were actually very creative. But back then I was a different person, so I didn't see it back then. You know, you grow up and you see things differently sometimes. But he always, you know, tried to get me into it, but I just never, you know. Maybe I was too insecure, or I don't know what was wrong, but I always had it around me. And then just suddenly, I can't remember when was that, where I made my, this channel, no, not this channel, because this is for the vlog channel. I made the other channel where I have my spiritual, my tarot cards on right now. I did, that is the first channel that I had ever made, where I just vlogged when me and Amanda was in LA, but again, I was very terrible at filming because it was shaky and oh my god, I didn't speak back then. I was so afraid to speak in videos. So that is also to give you guys hope. Like, if you are afraid to speak in videos, you just have to do it, you know, to overcome that. I overcame that pretty quickly. But if you look back at the other channel and like the older videos, you're going to notice that. Also on this channel, in the first videos, I didn't say much. Okay, I'm just fixing up the brows, trying to make them look like sisters, not twins, because again, brows are not twins. But I don't think they're going to be perfect today. I do feel we're going to deal with this. But I just got more and more into it because I love to film, but I always been insecure about it. Like to do it myself. I am using paint pot for the eyes. This is in soft oak. Is that what you call it? Oh, this camera. So I'm using this. It is the best. I mean, for me it works. So, but yeah, I just... Actually, one YouTuber that really got me into doing vlogging is Trisha Paytas. I don't know if any of you know who it is. Probably some of you know who it is. And I know that some people really hate her. But I like her. I mean, she's having some problems like all of us, you know. She's dealing with it. She's learning. And I like to support people who learn from their mistakes. And recently, she's really learning from her mistakes. She's still doing stupid things, but again, she's also living from YouTube. So, you know, obviously you do need to do stupid things. But I'm not always like, you know, I'm not always agreeing with her. Like marrying a cardboard, what do you call that? Like a paper figure of Brad Pitt is maybe just a bit strange. She has also been talking about why she had problems with abuse and like mental health. So, you know, I get it. But I saw her vlogs and I was like, wow, I want to do that. And back then I was like, I want to live in LA. I want to... So that's why there's so many LA vlogs from, you know, from back then. But again, I was very insecure about it. Because, yeah. I'm trying to find out what brushes I need to make. This one is maybe a little bit big. Oh, what brushes I need to make. What brushes I need to use. I might actually just use this. Because I need a flat brush. And I am using the palette Violet Voss. I'm using this so much. This is so dirty. But I do love this palette. And I'm going to start out with Thanks a Lot. You guys can also see that I've been using this a lot. So I'm going to put it on my lid. It's not the matte one. I am dipping it in the crystal. I am dipping it in the little shimmering one. Might actually use this. But yeah, Trisha was someone who inspired me, and I still love to watch her videos, her vlogs. When she's real and she's really vlogging, like you being at home vlogging, I love that. So yeah, that's what I want to do, but I can't do daily vlogs right now. I can't. I don't have material enough. Again, my customers don't, you know, not all my customers want to be on the camera. But in 2020, I am going to start out doing it. I'm going to vlog from my wake up till I go to bed. The boyfriend coming into my life better not have a problem with being on camera. Or having a problem with me filming. He doesn't have to be on camera. I'm going to use the bestie. Would you please focus on it? I don't think it can. Because it's stupid. But maybe it's too, because these colors are a little bit more warm and I don't want to have warm colors. So I'm actually going to take another palette. Okay, I just took this one. What is it from? Laura. Laura Geller. And I'm going to, I don't know what this is called. Sahara, I think it's called Sahara. Sahara, this one. Another question that I got recently on this channel is, what YouTubers I am watching at the moment. It is a month ago that I got that question, but at the moment is my moment now. And I actually recently found a Danish YouTuber. I normally don't watch Danish YouTubers, but I do today. And I actually randomly found her because me and Kiri are going to UK next year in February, if everything goes well. And I always have the tendency where I watch like London vlogs before that we go to London, because I love that, it's cozy. So that's how I actually found her. And I know that a lot of my viewers are like, you are from other countries, not so much Danish. I do have some Danish people watching my channel, but not many. But you know, I do still want you guys to go just take a look at her. Because she's actually pretty, you know, there's just something about her. And you guys know me, I have this like, I do like real people and I do like people who really, you know, do what they love to do. And she's really doing that. But she's doing Vlogmas at the moment. And I'm just really, I love watching it. There's just something about that girl. And she's also from the south of, maybe not at the south, but she's like from, what we call Jylland. Maybe I'm going to do a collab with her so you guys can meet her one day. You never know. But I'm going to put, you know, it here. She's doing fitness and stuff. Oh my god, if I had the power to do more fitness, I would be happy. Of course I have the power. But I am watching her at the moment. Who else am I watching? Well, Trisha. Trisha! Oh, another YouTuber that I'm actually watching, it's Theodore. I can't remember her name, I'm gonna put his name here. But he's doing makeup, he's like, yee-hoo! He's really a power person. So, yay for that. I don't know what's up with me finding Danish YouTubers. Who else am I watching? Well, obviously, The Haunted Side. Hello Patrick, if you're watching. I did actually talk with Patrick about doing like haunted videos together. And I am actually going to, I mean, me and Amanda did this, like we put it out in the future where we say to each other we are going to LA at that point, and sometimes we go to LA, you know, earlier. But she's also self-employed and there's a lot of changes going on in her life. So you know, the money aspect of going to LA needs to be fixed with her before that we can do it. But August, I know that's a long time ahead, but we've been speaking about going to LA and staying there for longer. 3 weeks around 3 weeks. And we are actually flying from Germany to Vegas. So we are starting out the trip in Vegas this time, and we are going to rent a car and drive to LA. So we're going to do it that way. But that is the plan right now. And then let's see, you know, maybe it's going to happen earlier, depending on her business, depending on, you know, me. I do want to do eyeliner today. There's also, I mean, I do actually like to watch, Kendall Ray and the Mile Higher podcast. I love to watch that. I do also follow Oh My Gosh TV, is that what he's called? I'm trying to go through, you know, who am I actually following on YouTube. I do also love to watch Aisha Cupcake, I think that's her name, because again, she's just real. I love her. She's so funny. Obviously, Shanetta Bing. You guys have met Shanetta in my videos. But I'm trying to find the other one that I wanted to talk about. Oh, there's also Dan Bell. He's also doing like haunted things or abandoned things. I also do follow Dark Arts Paranormal or Dark Arts TV, but I, again, because of another person, I don't really have that much to do with them anymore. Well, you guys know that if you follow my channel. Exploring with Kobe, exploring with that is the first explorers ever that I followed years back. Oh, obviously Shane Dawson and Jeffree Star. It's Black Friday, I love to watch her too. He's not posting that much anymore. I'm also going to give a shout out for one of my it's one of my old friends. We just got connected again, started speaking with each other again. And not because that we had any fight, but you know, life just put us apart. But it is Yanaitis. Did I say that right, Matthew? It is Matthew. I will put his I will put all links in the description box so you guys can go follow. But I want you guys to go follow Matthew. Again, I will put it here too, because that he's doing music and he's amazing. I met Matthew through CKY back when they were in Denmark, Copenhagen. That was again, why didn't I vlog back then? Who else do I follow? Obviously Kiri. You guys know Kiri. You guys love Kiri. I can't find it. Life of Tom. I also follow Life of Tom. A British, he's not a gamer, but he's more like, is he making games? I can't remember. Markiplier, Jacksepticeye. Oh my God. Markiplier's voice. Yes. Jacksepticeye's blue eyes. His Irish accent. We also have Makeup Junkie. I love that girl because she is like, I can't remember what her, what you call it. I can't remember. I'm not even going to try to say it because I don't want to say anything wrong, because I don't mean anything wrong. But go follow her because she's, I mean, she's a fighter. I adore her so much. I actually saw a documentary about her. That's how I found her. So this is just, you know, YouTubers that I really, really follow. By the way, this is Erica. More of Erica, the Danish YouTuber. Again, I am a very good, like, you know, I support other YouTubers because that's what you do. You support them, you do, you like other people's videos, you do comments. I love people who do that. I know that Patty Negri also, she's also on YouTube. Ruka Angel is also on YouTube. You guys also know her. Santino, also one of my friends from LA that I've been hanging out with a lot. He's also on YouTube. You guys know him from one of my vlogs that I did in LA. Santino is a Scorpio. You do understand why if you see him. A Scorpio with all his heart. Who else we have? Steph Sanjati. I'm not even gonna try to say it, but it's this. I know a lot of you guys know it. I love to follow them. I have really been a big fan of following following. I can't remember his name now. But one thing that I do have a problem with overdramatic content of fakeness. And I'm not saying that they are faking things, but they just did some videos where they said that they faked it. Okay, we're doing YouTube. We're doing YouTube. Yes, we are. We're doing eyeliner. I know, guys, I'm talking a lot, but this is a talking video, okay? I just saw 11:11. Let's try to do eyeliner. But again, I do like to help people, you know, on YouTube, other people, or other YouTubers. Sometimes I'm also too kind, I know that. Whew. I don't know what I'm doing today. Is this eyeliner dramatic? It probably is. Was it supposed to be dramatic? Probably. What else can I talk about? I think I did an oopsie. Maybe I could fix the oopsie. I don't know if I can fix the oopsie. But I'm also going to Paris at some point. I have one of my friends, Eddie. We speak a lot together. We joke a lot, you know. It's like this person that sometimes we feel like we are a married couple without being together. He's in another relationship. It's just sometimes the way that we speak together, it's so funny. He's again, being Aquarius, he's just crazy. He's been a lot in my ex-boyfriend's vlogs when there's one or two videos, I think. Again, but I do actually think that he put down all the videos with me. I wonder why. So they're probably not there anymore. But I've been speaking with Kiri about going to Paris. And then, you know, I'm obviously going to see Eddie again. He did talk about like taking us to the catacombs, showing us the catacombs. I am just using a very boring Maybelline mascara because again, I don't have my magical mascara anymore. I use this one from Helene Rubinstein. This is the best one, but it is dry. I'm not going to use lashes because I don't need them. I don't need to be that fancy. The last question from the girl, I can't remember. You're from Sweden. Sweden is like the, I already messed up. The, you know, how I got on this spiritual path. And I always had this like paranormal maybe, but the spiritual is something that's in my family because my mom did, you know, tarot cards when I was younger. She did mediumship. Like, I remember that when I was a kid, sometimes when I got back from school, we had strangers in the house who got a reading, or people who, my mom did the thing back then. Whereas she could, you know, spirit could speak through her and say things. I was always very fascinated about that. I remember that at some point when I was small, I was running around under the table and like creeping around while she was doing a reading for someone. It was a family member she did it for, so I don't think they were bothered that much about it, but that is just something that I remember clearly. So I grew up with in a family where we did that. My mom also teaches me with the pendulum. The pendulum that I have is a pendulum that my grandmother had, so it's an old one and it's magical. So I always, you know, it has always been in my family. I did have an experience when I was a kid where I woke up and I saw a light figure and a dog. So random. That frightened me so much. And the only thing I can remember is that I wanted to scream and I wanted to cry, but I couldn't. So I guess that is the first experience that I had, and I shut it off. I always did like paranormal things, but again, I've been closing down for it a lot. But then there was this person that I've been speaking a lot about. It's because of him that I started out doing like the spiritual YouTube thing. Because again, that's also a thing that I always wanted to do, but I never thought that I could. I was always afraid to do it. Like, especially this, oh my God, I can't speak English to people because I never wanted to do it in Danish. I am Danish, but I never really had this Danish connection in myself. And I know from again from psychic people, that it's linked together with a past life, that I have in a past life been living in California. And it's funny because I've always been very drawn to California. I'm just going to fix up my little mistakes I made. But I will say that I'm very grateful for that person who brought me on the spiritual awakening, because again, instead of being like hating on people who broke your heart, then be like, well, thank you. Thank you for teaching me the lessons that I needed to learn, you know? And that's what I've been doing. I think this is it for the makeup. I am going to do something with the hair, and I'm just going to continue filming because that's what we do. I might do some kind of curls or something. I don't even know what I want to do. This winter is really, I mean, it is messing up my hair very quickly. I do try not to wash it every day. That's also why I use a lot of this Baptiste dry shampoo. This is the best. I mean, it is the best. So I'm just going to use this a little bit. Yee-hoo! I always use it when I have customers and they love it. They're like, oh my god, how did you do that? With a magical spray in a can. But yeah, I am trying to be more like feminine, to be more cute. Like, I also got a dress from the Boohoo page. So, you know, I am trying to be more like, again, instead of going around with big clothes and hiding myself, you know, why should I do that? I want to be myself. I don't know if I want to do curls, but then again, talking about that I need to be more feminine. I might just do a little bit. I'm not going to do a lot. I was like, I know that one of my customers gave me this little. This is the best hairspray brand you can get. It is German, so I don't know if you can get it in the States, but this is the best. So I'm just going to. A good tip is like what you call it. If you want to do curls or do something in your hair, put hairspray first. That is it really makes, you know, it makes it all work. But I'm not doing big curls today, I'm just doing messy curls. And I never use this one. I know a lot of my customers are going to be happy to see this because they're always like fascinated about the way that I do curls in their hair. I have so much hair now. Well, long hair. I didn't just want to, but a little bew. I just feel my hair is really, it's becoming so much longer now that it's hard to make curls with the little one. But I always actually put it up in a big, you know, I don't know what you call that. And then I do the curls like that. But I'm not going to do that today. I'm just trying to do a little bit more here. But it does have a little. What is wrong with this? Well, I did put like a hair mask in, so it can be the reason why my hair is not really cooperating. But yeah, after I'm like more open to the paranormal, you know, the paranormal is more open to me. I guess that's how you can say it, that they try to communicate more with me. Doesn't do that, I'm not all alone now. But working with this mediumship and this like psychic and paranormal, and it really also, like with my customers that I have, I tend to attract customers who need my help. Like yesterday, the last customer I had, she really, I have had her before. And she's normally very happy, very bubbly. She's also a Libra. And you know, when we texted, I could already there feel there was something wrong. But a lot of things, I mean, she's really been going through a lot of things. So, you know, we just spoke a lot, and that's why I gave her like the last piece of Palo Santo, because also she wanted to work with angel cards, but needed a little push. So again, one thing is that I have my customers, but I also just tend to help them with so many things, many other things than just taking pictures. So it does give my hair a little bit more volume to do this. I'm so sore in my my body because I, again, started to work out again. I have pain everywhere. I probably should do something with the hair soon, like get, maybe cut it a little bit. I actually had a dream last night where I had short hair and I also had blonde hair. That was so strange. But this is just a cozy Christmas Christmas video. But yeah, I do want to do more YouTube. But I also want to travel more. I don't know what I'm doing right now. I'm just doing it. I am not really being a perfectionist right now. I don't know what happened with the camera. But it just suddenly, it just went black. Paranormal. Okay, so I'm going to take the hair down and I'm going to use more of this and a little bit of hairspray. See you guys. Because we need to make it big. Well, as big as it can be. So it does have a little, like, a little curly. I have these tiny baby hairs now. I know this is not really curled that well. Oh, the struggle. Try not to put hairspray close to the flames because then it's going to say I'm not up for that right now. But if you guys have other questions, just put them in the comments. I still have a lot of questions that I need to answer from the other page, but that's not going to be a part of this. I know some people also been asking about how I protect myself. Again, I do work a lot with like visualization. I visualize light around me or also one thing, oh, something's wrong here, that I started out doing is before I have customers, I do the thing where I put light around them because again, if I have customers who is in a bad mood or something, they're not going to show that off, if that makes sense. You guys know what I mean. They're not going to, you know, be negative. They're suddenly just going to see things in another way. Be relaxed also. I know from my customers that I have a tendency that people really feel safe when I have shoots with them. Like, people are like, wow. People who are afraid to get their pictures taken. Because yes, that is something that is happening for some people. And the confidence, and like, you know. Again, I'm very grateful that I have the ability to help people in that way. The blondness is already shining through. I don't know what to do. Camera, focus on me. I do have a lot of red. Oh, MAC lipsticks. I do also, I couldn't find what I was looking for, so I might take the paper flower color from Necromancy. I love this brand. They have sponsored me in the past. Oh, sponsored. I don't know if it's sponsored. It's like, you know, me doing a photo shoot for the brand. And after I just, you know, I just brought my own lipsticks, because the first lipsticks that I got when I worked with Bottom, when I did shoots, was like in the beginning. Their products has really, you know, evolved. Is that how you say it? Say evolved? Evolved. I might take this because again, I can't find my other lipsticks. I don't know if it's too dark. There was a time in my life where I really loved to walk around with dark lipsticks, and now I'm a little bit more like, okay, this has to be it. But they are very cute, the lipsticks. And it is vegan. So if anyone out there is like obsessed with that. But I also feel that this might be it. The makeup is just, I mean, you know, it's a normal makeup, but this probably took forever because I was talking so much. But again, that's what this video is all about. Talking. I am going to put all the stuff, you know, away. And then I'm going to get ready to film readings. I do have Earth, the monthly Earth readings that I need to do, and then I will see if I can do something else, because there was something else I wanted to film today, but I also have to edit pictures. You know, the struggle of being self-employed. The struggle of working. I don't know what to do with my hair. My hair is a little bit... my hair is not happy. But this is it, guys. I hope you guys enjoyed this longer talk, get ready with me video. Please let me know in a comment below. It will help me out a lot. If you want to like this video and subscribe, become a part of this family. Also, again, in the end of this video, there is a link to my other channel as well. But for now, I'm going to sign off and say thank you for watching. I will see you guys in my next video. Bye. We can do what we like.